Dutchman Michael Waterman is part of a violin-playing Concertgebouw family dynasty. He is fifth in an unbroken line of violinists that have been playing in the Concertgebouw orchestra. And you'd think that him having his parents in the orchestra was a good enough reason for him wanting to join the orchestra, but that's not the case at all. It's an entirely different story. Mikey, you once told me that your audition here was the most nerve-wracking day of your life. Why?
I think an audition is pretty much anybody's most nerve-wracking day ever. The most nerve-wracking thing about it is really the stakes that, you know, you're playing for a job in an orchestra, this one or any other one, and really it will change your life forever.
But the stakes for you were higher than most.
For me, I just carried around this weight of everybody knows me, so. The other thing was that my fiancé at the time was in the US, and for her to come here, Michael needed to win a job. So, no win is no fiancé.
Right, no pressure at all then.
No.
So, let's go to the family dynasty then that we keep talking about.
It's a big word, but okay,
It is, but actually it's very appropriate for your family. Just run us through which members of your family have been here and...
Well, this started in 1950. My grandfather joined as a violinist. And then my uncle, my father, and my mom also joined after, also all as violinists. And when I joined in 2010, at that moment, both my parents were still working in the orchestra. So yeah, and what would be really cool is if I managed to hold on to this job for another 30 years, because then there will be a Waterman violinist in this orchestra for 100 years.
Wow. So the first time you came in as a professional was actually quite young. How old were you?
I was 19.
Right, as a remplaçant, so you got called. Can you come in and play for the week?
The manager called me, said, can you play this week in November? I said, absolutely fine. So this fantastic, legendary conductor, Lauren Mazel, was going to come in that week. So that's a great start. Mazel was famous for bringing his own music. So in this particular case, he brought a piece which was called Lion's Roar. So I opened the Lion's Roar, and the first page is full of black notes, which is basically as fast as possible. So I go to my mom, and I ask her, so mom, so this first page, so this seems really difficult. I mean, this is really like this. And she says, well, don't stress out about it too much. Practice it, prepare, but it's...
It'll be part of the noise.
It'll be part of something.
Right.
Okay, so I took this advice. I prepared as well as I could. We get to the first morning. We start the first rehearsal at 9:30 with Lion's Roar. And so we all start playing. And at 9:30, 1:30, he says, no, stop. I wrote these notes, and it's not supposed to be that you just make up your own. Let's have the second violins. And so I look over to my mom, and she said, okay, here we go. I said, well, you didn't tell me we were going to be going. So what do you mean? So he managed to make us play the entire passage.
Oh, that's fantastic.
And we were all going like the six of us, which must have sounded fantastic. And then I went home and I practiced the whole rest of the day to get ready for the next day, and he never returned to it. It was absolutely just to use us to prove a point.
Wow. Well, what a...
That was my first morning.
Wow, welcome. Welcome to the friendly orchestra that is the Concertgebouw Orchest. Well, he was an extraordinary character, that's for sure. So your actual violin, that was your father's violin, right?
Well, actually, it was my father's violin, but before this, it was actually my grandfather's violin. He had a nose for it, and he was interested in the instrument, so he bought some really nice violins and bows, and so... Yeah, it has a lot of emotional value.
What does the violin mean to you?
This is just my life. I can't imagine not doing this. It's hard to describe in words what that is. To sit on the stage and do that together with 100 people is impossible to explain.
Well, what an extraordinary thing. Thank you, Mikey. What an amazing story, and to see all those Waterman names on the walls of our orchestral house here is fantastic, you know. Great. Well, let's hope that you make the 2050 mark.
One day at a time.